Hey, what's up, guys? So welcome back. It's almost end of the week. I'm filming this on a Friday. So wanted to compare Vancouver versus Munich, especially because past 3 days it's been clear blue sky, sunny, and a beautiful like rainbow sunset with Alps on the southern view. If you look to the south, I see like a clear mountain lines and Alps. It's so beautiful here. So I just really wanted to say, because I was talking to my coworker today at the company lunch, that he's also from Vancouver and I lived in Vancouver as well. So, you know, compared to Vancouver, the gray overcast and like depressing weather with the rain and then a little bit of, you know, wind chill and horizontal wind here compared to Vancouver, it's like sunny or snowy and no rain. And we are talking about how we had only 3 or 2 days of rainy days in this winter. So I really like so much better the weather here. It's like maybe 2 times or 3 times better in terms of like in the mood, overall mood that I'm having and feeling because of the sunshine that we are getting. And with the sun, it's a little much more warmer. Today was like 7 degrees Celsius. And with the sun, it was really nice. Relaxing, soothing. So that's definitely winning for Munich compared to Vancouver. So that's one thing. And another thing is that temperature, I think we had like -2 or -5 at night, -7 even. But I didn't really quite notice it because, you know, at home, like inside, there's always this called the water, hot water heater thing turned on. In my apartment, I don't need to pay extra for heating, which is really awesome. So I only pay for electricity, for like lights or like a fridge. So inside, like at home, I don't feel cold at all because heater is always on. And outside is a little cold, but transportation is pretty good, which is the case, the same for Vancouver as well. So I can just go to bus stop or go to train station. So just 2 minutes maximum, like walking to the public transportation. So, which is really nice. And even if it's snowing, it's just snow. My walk to transit, like bus station, so it doesn't really bother me. I think you can, probably this is a, I think, no, probably the same. For Vancouver, transportation is pretty nice. So in this case, I don't feel much negative side about having the really low temperature here. And inside is always nice, which is the case for Canada as well. Japan is a little different. Japan is much a little bit milder and warmer, but inside a house, they don't have a nice like, controlled, managed central heating system. So and the window is really thin compared to here, it's thicker, or like 2 layers. So it's really cold in Japan, whereas here I don't feel cold inside when I'm sleeping. So this is a thing that comes down to, you know, winter time. Because the summertime, Vancouver is actually pretty nice, like blue sky, dry air, no rain, just sun, sunny days with mountains and the beach, and you can do hiking or you can go to beach. So sunny days in the summertime in Vancouver is really awesome, which is kind of comparable to like Munich summer days here as well, because we have river, English garden, like a park, Massen Park, and also you can go to Alps, like 1 hour away from here. And sunny days in the summertime, it's not so humid here either, so sunny days are comparable to Vancouver. So winter time definitely, you know, Munich gets extra points. So this is something that we are talking about in like we are doing a comparison between Vancouver and Munich with my coworker from Vancouver. Then we also talk about food as well, because we both like seafood, and seafood wise definitely Vancouver wins. And not just seafood, but Asian food in general. So like Vietnamese, Thai food, Vancouver has so much more variety, and also quality is much higher because they're actually, you know, real restaurant chefs cooking their own like cuisines. Whereas here, Asian restaurants here tend to have like multiple, they try to serve multiple ethnic food. So let's say if you go to Chinese restaurant, they try to serve you, they actually serve Chinese, Indian, or Japanese sushi kind of thing. And let's say if you go to Indian restaurant, they serve you Thai, Chinese, and Indian. And if you go to Japanese restaurant, they serve you, excluding the authentic Japanese restaurant, if it's like owned by Chinese or Vietnamese, then they serve you Japanese sushi rolls and Chinese food or Vietnamese food. So it's kind of like a hybrid. They're trying to maximize profits, and then there are not many like real Chinese or real Vietnamese or real Japanese food that are as good in Vancouver as here. So food-wise, definitely Vancouver wins in terms of price. Price-wise, in Munich, it's a little bit higher for the quality that we are getting. I cannot say too much, say so much about food here because I haven't eaten out in Munich by myself except once. So all the time that I'm eating out is through a company lunch, and we went to like an Italian restaurant, Chinese, Greek, and then whatnot, and they're pretty good. But I haven't been to like a Japanese restaurant in Munich to really try out like sushi quality because I know it's not gonna be as good in Vancouver. But salmon could be really good because it's imported from Norway. Norway, pretty nice salmon with like fat. So yeah, food-wise, expensiveness and quality-wise, Vancouver is much, much better, I guess. I remember on Davie Street, there's like Samurai Sushi. It's like for like $6 or $7 Canadian. They serve you like a big, massive like rolls. It was pretty good. Was here, I guess because it's far away from the ocean, and then German people don't really eat seafood, so price tend to be a little more expensive. And quality-wise, are not many really competition here, and also not many people can really tell good or bad. So I guess it's pretty dull competition here, like market-wise. So again, pros and cons, Munich and Vancouver. However, I was talking to my another coworker who just moved to Germany from the United States. I had a work experience in Canada and the United States as well, but he moved from the United States to Germany, and we are talking about vacation days. And he said the company, previous company he was working, 3 weeks he couldn't take a kind of 3 weeks vacation, like maximum like 12 or 15, 12 days or like 2 weeks, and he can't take it all, take the 2 weeks, entire 2 weeks at once. I think it was just a company policy. I'm not saying all the US companies are like that, but in general, compared to Canadian companies, American companies tend to have more strict rules for like kind of expectation for vacations. They tend to work longer, and vacation days tend to be shorter than Canadian one. And then compare that even to Germany, we were talking, coworker and me, I are talking. That minimum vacation days we get here is 4 weeks or 20 days or so or 25 days, and then that's a minimum for all the jobs, right? So if you're a software engineer, that we all the companies usually give us like minimum 25 or 30 days. 30 days is 6 weeks, and our company policy is unlimited vacation, so uncapped, kind of like a Facebook does. Facebook gives you uncapped, unlimited holidays. So compared to United States, like holiday policy here is like minimum 6 weeks kind of, whereas where he was working at previously, he was getting only like 12 days. This is like 2.5 weeks, and salary wise it's not like that super high compared to here, unless you work at like tech Silicon Valley, San Fran kind of big ass company, then it doesn't necessarily mean like just working in the United States doesn't necessarily mean like so much higher pay. So overall, like what he was getting with like vacation days converted to money, like a salary, then it would have been like not much more in the United States with like a social benefit and all that included, then like pretty questionable. So that's kind of like a kind of casual conversation that we had, and it's kind of cool to be able to see like what it's like to work in different countries with a different social system or vacation policy, social what is it called, health insurance, and then social benefits, and then all sorts of aspects, come into play when it comes to like working in a specific country in a city, because every countries have different rules, regulations, and then holiday policies. And just because you're getting paid more doesn't necessarily mean that quality of life is going to be higher. You need to factor in like cost of rent. So my coworker and I were talking in the United States, right? And you get like 12 days, and if you try to travel to somewhere, at least like if you're trying to go to another state, you need to drive, and driving takes time. So you can only take a one trip out of 1 year. Plus, if you're going to fly, other than South America, if you're going to like Asia or Europe, then it'll take more time. So like 12 days, you can't really do much. Like 2 or 3 days gonna be gone for just transit time. So you can only do like one semi big trip, and that's it in the United States if you're getting 12 days. It's a different story if you're getting 20 or 25. Whereas here, we get 6 weeks plus, right? Minimum 6 weeks, let's say. And you also, all the cities and countries are, nearby. So he was talking about, like, let's say if you're going to fly to Barcelona, Spain, or Greece, it's like a few hours flight. And then, cheaper, shorter, transit time, and you get more vacation, so you get more out of the so lifestyle wise this is like so much better. And I cannot agree with him more. And that's one of the important factor that made me make a decision to move from North America to Europe, especially Germany here. So it's interesting how in different countries, the life could be completely different. Even if you're the same job, you're working the same job, and your work-life balance or like your quality of life, what do you prioritize? Like maybe family time or your traveling, adventure time, or personal time off, as opposed to just work and work and work, or even just no transportation. United States, or let's say Australia, it's so disconnected from the rest of the world. In terms of like logistics and connectivity wise, compared to like here, it's ultra connected here, which is not average. So I don't take this for granted. It feels pretty grateful about this location. But yeah, so definitely, if you wanna have that kind of more time for vacation or traveling or family time, then definitely here much better. And I don't think anybody's gonna disagree that family, if you're prioritizing family time or vacation or traveling, that here is one of the best. United States or Canada is subpar compared to like here. And this is a quantifiable objective metric that you can compare. So I can definitely say that I made a upgrade. I did upgrade my lifestyle and different aspects in lifestyle by moving here. So it's great. It's great to feel here, and great to feel like I'm getting. I got what I wanted to. I pursued, and this is not the wrong decision. And if you're looking to change your career or change location, city, you wanted to, change up some aspects with your life, and you're thinking about making a move to, let's say, Germany as a software engineer, like tech, then definitely, I can say that, it's in certain aspects, it'll be much better for you. There are different aspects for sure. Like rent is gonna be, could be higher than other cities here, but definitely lower than Vancouver, definitely lower than San Fran, definitely lower than London or New York or Paris or Amsterdam. Of course, you're gonna pay a lot of tax, like 42% ish or something. And so it's a social contribution, you're gonna pay a lot. So here, Germany is like highest tax rate, one of the highest tax rates in the world. But yeah, depends, depends. But yeah, I just wanted to, talk about this, because this is the kind of things that we talk about in my workplace, because all the people are international and we can exchange information. That's kind of benefit of like working in an international work environment. So if you hope to do something like that, then yeah, gladly I can share some information. So well, that said, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions, then let me know. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye, ciao ciao.